Welcome everyone to the PV online course. So far we have looked at the behavior of a p-n-junction in thermal equilibrium in the dark. In this lesson we will regard a p-n-junction without thermal equilibrium. We'll take a closer look at what happens when we apply a voltage at the p-n-junction or when we illuminate it. First, however, we consider a p-n-junction in the dark, which we short-circuit. If we now look at the diffusion and the drift current densities of the holes and the electrons, we can see that all currents are exactly equal. The charge carrier currents are in equilibrium, so in the dark there is no net current flow in the short-circuit p-n-junction. We recall that the drift current moves the minorities in both regions, that is, the electrons in the P regions and the holes in the N region. It counteracts the diffusion current. The diffusion current, on the other hand, moves the majorities, that means the electrons in the N region and the holes in the P region. We now apply a voltage source with approximately 600 millivolt to the p-n-junction, so that the negative pole is connected to the N region and the positive pole to the P region. At this polarity, we call the bias voltage forward voltage. The forward voltage creates an electric field which counteracts the electric field created by the p-n-junction. This reduces the electric field of the p-n-junction and the width of the depletion region is narrowed. Let us first consider what this means for the drift current densities. As the electric field decreases, the drift current densities of the minorities also decrease. For the diffusion current densities, the effect is opposite. Since the width of the depletion region is narrowed, dx is decreased and thus dn by dx is increased at the same time. That means the diffusion current densities of the majorities increase. In sum, holes are transported into the N region where they are attracted by the negative pole and electrons into the P region where they are attracted by the positive pole. In sum, the forward voltage results in a net current flow in forward direction. As a reminder, the band diagram of a p-n-junction in thermal equilibrium is shown again. The minority charge carriers are transported to the opposite regions by the drift current. At the same time, diffusion causes energetic minority carriers to overcome the electric field and diffuse into the region where there are minority charge carriers. Now let us apply a forward voltage to the p-n-junction. As we have seen, the electric field is reduced. At the same time, the band bending is reduced. The electric field causes the electrons to drift from the p to the n region. Since the electrons are the minorities in the P region, the drift current is very small. At the same time, energetic electrons diffuse from the N to the P region. Since the band bending is now lower, more electrons have enough energy to climb the potential barrier caused by the electric field. The same is true for the holes, of course. The difference between the two energy levels equals elementary charge times diffusion voltage minus applied voltage. Since there is now an external voltage applied to the semiconductor, it is no longer in equilibrium. Therefore, the Fermi level is no longer constant across the semiconductor. Far away from the space charge region, the Fermi level corresponds to the Fermi level at equilibrium. We now consider the p-n-junction at reverse bias of about 0.6 volt in the dark. The N region is now connected to the positive pole and the P region to the negative pole. The electric field of the voltage amplifies the electric field of the P-n junction. In sum, the electric field increases, so does the depletion region. Due to the larger electric field, the drift current density of the minority can increase. The larger width of the depletion region decreases dN by dx, and thus the diffusion current densities of the minorities. Overall, the drift currents dominate. However, since the drift currents are proportional to the minority charge carriers concentration, and these are very small, only a very small current flow occurs. This extremely small current flow is also called reverse saturation current. Let us have a look at the band diagram of the p-n junction under reverse bias. In contrast to the forward bias, the band bending increases here. The minority charge carriers are transported to the opposite region by the drift current. However, there are very few minority charge carriers, so the drift current is very small. For the diffusion current, the picture is as follows. Since the potential barrier is now very steep, there are hardly any electrons that have enough energy to be transported to the P region by diffusion. Although the drift current is very small, it dominates the reverse saturation current flows. Again, the difference between the two energy levels equals elementary charge times diffusion voltage minus applied voltage. But since the voltage now has a negative sign, the overall voltage increases. As under forward bias, the reverse bias, the Fermi level is not constant across the semiconductor anymore. If we illuminate the p-n junction with light, additional electron hole pairs are generated. The minorities, for example electrons in the n region, do not matter in each case. However, the concentration of minority carrier increases by several orders of magnitude. Remember the examples with princes and princesses. Since the minority charge carrier densities increase by several orders of magnitude, the drift current densities of the minorities increase in the same way. The electrons are transported into the N region, the holes into the P region. A significant current flow occurs. This current flows through the circuit even though no external voltage has been applied. This is the short circuit current. The current caused by solar radiation is called photocurrent. At full solar radiation of 1000 watt per square meter, it is about 10 billion times larger than the dark current in a silicon solar cell. Thus, the short circuit current is approximately equal to the photocurrent. It flows in the same direction as the reverse current in reverse direction. Let us now open the circuit. Additional electron hole pairs are created by illumination, as in the previous slide. The minorities are transported by the drift currents, and a voltage will be built up at the open terminals caused by the additional charge carrier pairs separated at the depletion region. This voltage is called open circuit voltage. It has the same polarity as a p-n junction operated in forward direction. Let's look at the current flow in the band diagram. The photoelectric effect significantly increases the number of minority charge carriers. The electrons are transported to the neighboring N region by the electron slide. Since there is no change in the band bending compared to the thermal equilibrium, electrons continue to diffuse in reverse direction, but they are few compared to the photogenerated charge carriers. In sum, a significant current flows in reverse direction. Let's summarize. In thermal equilibrium, drift and diffusion current densities balance each other out. If we put the p-n junction under forward bias, the diffusion current densities of the minority dominate and overall a current in forward direction occurs. Under reverse bias, on the other hand, the drift current densities of the minorities dominate. Since there are only a few minority carriers, the overall current is very small. The resulting current is called reverse saturation current. Finally, if we illuminate the p-n junction, many electron-hole pairs are created and the minority densities increase significantly. The electron-hole pairs are separated by the depletion region and transported to the electrons. A current much higher than in the dark is flowing, the photocurrent. Thank you for your attention.